to Fallout 4. Pip-Boy in the corner. New game. Start a new game? Yes, please! May I have one? Alright, so again, just kind of giving you guys the ground. Every 6 hours the first week, and then probably once a day from then on. Going to wait for your guys' feedback on how much extracurricular activity you want me to show. For this first week, I'll be trying to skip some of the just random looting. I'll try and stick to action adventure-y stuff on camera, and I'll try and do the inventory and looting off camera, either pausing or doing little cuts to get rid of some of the just more just monotonous looting of the town, towns nearby and whatnot. But here we go.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen.
Aww.
He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers.
I call that portable.
In the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077.
Great.
We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
Just the tools of war. All right.
Never changes.
So, obviously, amazing character customization. Really looking forward to when the modders get a hold of this and swap out all the hair textures and whatnot. But I've kind of been thinking through what I wanted to play and how I want to play this, my first playthrough. And I want to go with a female character. So we're going to go with her. And so we'll have her get...
My turn, big guy.
Get up to the camera here. Hello. And I'm going to go with kind of, I guess you'd call it kind of a ranger, kind of a ranged attack, stealthy, intelligent kind of character. So that's kind of what my thought is here. So let's just see some of the presets. All right, let's look through here. See what their presets look like. Sometimes I'll go with a preset and then switch up. But their presets are all fairly similar. I like the hair on two. We'll start with that as a base. So let's go ahead and let's look through some of the features. So basically, you can kind of drag to adjust all the features, which is really kind of cool. You can just grab the different parts. Can't do anything with the hair. Yeah, that's just to give her some high cheekbones.
Such a great smile.
Let's do the chin here. Not weird jaw. I want to make her reasonable.
That looks nice.
Yeah, let's go with the eyeballs here. Oh, this is just kind of a spacing. A and D lets me kind of rotate them. Straight. Okay. And yeah. So I'm seeing they can get bigger or smaller. Doesn't seem to be making a huge difference there. Oh, her eyes are like way set back weird. Can we pull them out? We can. Okay. All right. And
such pretty eyes.
Let's go with the types.
I think Sean has my eyes.
Rested, tired. Prominent.
Sean totally has your eyes.
Piercing. Shrewd.
Yeah, I like that.
Oh, it's a creepy smile. Creepy smile! Creepy smile! Stranger danger.
You do know you've got the most beautiful eyes I've ever seen.
Really? Those are the most beautiful eyes you'd ever see if she was looking out of them. Alright, let's go with that.
Still got it.
Let's sculpt them a little bit more. Can I do anything? Okay. Now they're a little... Oh god, we're getting into weirdness now.
You do know you
and color... Steel blue, beautiful. All right, hair. Again, I like that hair, but let's just see what else we got here to go work with. Oh, nice. I think I had a couple of these styles in Skyrim. Alright, so.
I have the best hairdresser, I swear.
Yikes! Yeah, I go with deep brown. And.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Is there an overall... Let's take a look here. F. Nope. So this is where we can kind of define her. And she's going to be muscular because she's going to be kind of the ex-military-ish... Rawr. Yeah, ex-military, you know. Right, so we go kind of more on the muscular side. Because she's going to be strong. We've got to make sure she can pack a lot of stuff. That's why. What is this dude doing? Dude, you're looking kind of weird there. Alright, so we'll go kind of in that range. Alright. And give her, yeah, because just obviously if you're in the after a nuclear war, obviously you've gotta have some makeup on, otherwise, you know, a little radiation damage maybe. Yeah, maybe a little bit of radiation damage.
Yeah, oops. That works.
Didn't I? Oops. Oh, apply it. There we go. No, not that one. Oof. Not the rough, banged up. Yeah, just the forehead blemishes and that. Yeah, I think that's good. And I think cancel, no. Anything else to go here? I think otherwise that we're pretty much, so we can't really change. Oh, it does change kind of overall. Okay, so let's go with the chestnut. No, amber's good. I like it. I like it. There we go. And her name is going to be Ridley. So that will be my thing. So we're done. Let's confirm my character and begin our adventures. Oh, what was that? Let me do one more thing here. I think I need to adjust. So we are playing on Ultra. All the settings are on Ultra. Let me turn it up just a little bit more. Turn the music down so it's going to be pretty much in the background. I want voices to be nice and loud for everybody to hear. Get the radio off so I don't get hit by anything on that. And like I said, all the display settings are on Ultra. And we'll turn dialogue subtitles on so you guys have a chance to read those. And general subtitles on as well. That way, if something happens and I don't read it, that way you guys have a chance of hearing it as well. Okay. Make our first save, I guess. All right, let's look around. Nate, my hubby. A sweet, sweet man. Incredibly talented Mr. Handy.
Another fine product of General Atomics International.
Oh, yeah.
Abraxo for all your cleaning needs.
Ah, good morning, Mum. Your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection.
Oh, that sounds quite good.
And today's newspaper just delivered.
Oh, very well.
More of the same.
The Boston Bugle. Good.
Hey, Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, Mum.
All right, thank you. You check around. We got some yummy. Some Coca Cola. Oh, dang, the kid. Now that's a cool mixer.
I know we were nervous at first.
It's the future.
I'm glad we got Codsworth.
Worth it.
So I've got a Juris Doctor and something.
Good old U.S. of A.
It's that salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Oh, I'll check the door.
Good morning.
Well, hello.
Vault Tech calling.
Vault Tech? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, ma'am, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault Tech is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters.
Well, very cool.
Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Why is it urgent?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, ma'am, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local
vault. Oh, that's handy.
Vault 111.
Oh, well, that sounds great.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Okay.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid. Splendid. Now, let's see.
All right, so this is where we put in all our stuff. So, again, I'm going to go with Ridley. And the way I've got myself kind of set up, I'm thinking, is we're going to go... Oops, I got to hit enter there. So strength is going to melee damage and how much you can carry. So carry weight is, in this game, any Bethesda game, carry weight is important. You always end up packing everything. So I'm going to go with strength 5 for that. Perception, I wanted to, like I said, I want to be kind of a more long-range gun-using kind of character. So I want to have a lot of, be able to do a lot of good long-range shots. So VATS, well, accuracy will help with that. And perception also, when on your compass, the perception will increase the range at which you can see things. So let's go ahead and go up here with a 6. Endurance, you know, overall fitness, health points, hit points, etc. And we're going to go with a 4. I'm not too worried about charisma. Yeah, you can get some additional dialogue options and you get better prices, but I'm going to just hope for stuff to adjust that. Intelligence, I'm going to go maybe about a 6. Agility, again, number of action points you've got while you're in VATS. And luck at 1, so it kind of levels it off. Means we're not going to be very lucky at things. It's one of those things where you're always going to be second guessing, like maybe I should have some more points here or there. Now, you do get the ability later on to upgrade your special points. So you're not stuck at these levels forever. And these unlock higher levels of perks as well. So I'll be able to get some advanced perks down the road. So let's go ahead and accept this.
That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
He seems awfully nervous.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Aw.
Good answer.
I have my moments. Hey, hon.
We should take Codsworth to be serviced
Sean
soon,
has been
don't you
changed,
think?
But he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Okay,
go
well,
ahead,
we'll
honey.
Check on Sean.
I'll be there in a second to help, okay?
Where do we put the baby? Ah, the baby's over here. Hello, little baby.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin?
Whee! Spinning Plains of Doom.
That's my boy. On his best behavior, just like his dad.
Aww. Well,
most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Let's get pumpkins instead. Carve jack-o'-lanterns.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Cosworth? Uh-oh. What's wrong?
Little slidey doors are cool. I like those a lot better than regular doors.
By flashes, blinding flashes.
What?
Sounds of explosions.
We're, what's going on?
Trying to get confirmation. We seem to have lost contact with
what
our affiliate
say?
Stations.
Oh no.
We do have coming in. That's
what?
Confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh crap. You see anything outside?
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
Oh God, let's go.
Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills.
Oh shit, let's run for it. Women and children first. Me especially. Run for it! Ah! Hurry up, honey! Whoa. I'm stuck in the river. I'm gonna die! I'm glad we just got signed up just in time.
Not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me.
I'm in. Get me in.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female.
Yes, that's my name.
Okay, go ahead.
Adult female.
Thank you.
Let me in.
Good luck, sir.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
This way. Everything we can.
They're going to fry.
Step on the platform! In the center!
Where's... Oh, good. There's Sean. You made it. Great.
Almost there. Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
Oh my God!
What the... Don't look at it! Don't get the bullet... Oh!
Shut the gun now!
Hold on!
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
God, we made it just in time. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Mrs. Whitfield, you're here too?
Step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
What's going on?
No need to worry, folks.
I don't know.
We'll get everyone situated in your new home.
All right,
Vault 111.
Me first.
A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
Vault 10 is here for you.
Left a minute.
All new residents.
Way, no, we don't. Don't get caught up.
Female.
You're safe now.
Yes, I am a female. Thank you for noticing.
Male and infant.
This one's good.
Step over to the table. Take a seat. This way, please. Welcome. Pick up a suit right over there.
You'll need your suit before we can take you further.
Right over there.
Thank you.
Now,
just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
We're already over here. Come on.
See?
Levels are good.
There you go. Good job.
Over there. Take a seat.
Oh, you're going to love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities.
Our home.
Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Sir?
Hey.
Oh, God, honey.
Move along.
What if they didn't make it?
Okay.
I know.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Oh, geez.
Prepared for the future, right?
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
It'll be okay.
It's got a window.
Mommy's right here. See? Honey?
Oh, I guess.
Could you help me?
Who is my little guy, huh?
I'm not going far. Aww. I'll just be over there.
The little plastic baby.
There she is, see?
Alright, let's get in the decontamination pod.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault.
This is kind of odd.
New life. What?
Resident secure.
What?
Occupant vitals normal.
Maybe a little elevated.
Procedure complete.
What procedure? What?
In.
Wait.
5, 4, 3, 2.
What the heck is going on? Alrighty then. So, it's not a vault, it's a cryo preservation.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Oh, we're gonna be able to get out of here? Yep. What the heck? What?
Open it.
Hey! Honey?
Is it open? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
What?
Come on here. No, come
on here. No. I got it.
Let the boy go.
Wait, hold on. Don't. Wait. Don't stop it, no.
Please, we still have a backup.
Backup. God. So they've killed my husband and stolen my baby and put me back on ice. Those bastards. And so it begins. Oh.
Come on. There has to be.
Can we get out of here?
Come on, come on, come on. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
I'll find Nate. Who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Oh. All right, friends, we're going to go ahead and call that an episode there. When we come back, we will begin exploring this frozen hell. Get out of here and start exploring the wasteland. So if you enjoyed it, click that like button. Leave me comments. Let me know what you guys think so far of the game. I know you guys have a lot of options to watch this, so I really appreciate the fact you're watching with me. And I hope you enjoy this playthrough. I'll talk to you later. Bye.